This week's Ask Dr. Durie question is an important one. The last few weeks have been very exciting, and this questioner wants to know, can I discuss the recent FDA approval of daratumumab? And obviously a very important and exciting question. We're all very pleased that this November 16th, the FDA approved daratumumab for the treatment of myeloma. And so daratumumab is now called Darzalex. This is the trade name that we're going to be using from now on. It is exciting that the Darzalex was approved in patients who've had at least three prior therapies, and or if they are resistant to IMiDs or proteasome inhibitors. So in other words, if they have previously received Revlimid or pomalidomide and are resistant to one of them, or Velcade or carfilzomib and are resistant to one of them. So this is a key aspect. So Darzalex is an IV infusion and is given as an initial therapy on a weekly basis. And so for the first 2 months of therapy, the Darzalex is given once a week. After that, it is given every 2 weeks for the next 4 months, which takes you through the first 6 months. After those first 6 months, the Darzalex is given once a month. The benefit of the Darzalex was pretty obvious in a single drug treatment, so that it was used as a single agent. And so this is very, very important for a new drug, that it has benefit by itself. And two trials were submitted to the FDA, and each of those trials showed a significant benefit, one of them with a response rate of 29% and the other with a benefit of 36%. And so what this means is that in those two studies, there was a reduction or improvement in the myeloma protein level of at least 50% in these responding patients. So really remarkable benefit for a single agent. And so it is exciting that this is the first monoclonal antibody to be approved for myeloma, in this case against the CD38 antigen on the surface of the myeloma cells. And so myeloma consistently has CD38 on its surface. And so the anti-CD38 monoclonal antibody is a consistent therapy that can work against the myeloma. So very, very important. As a monoclonal antibody, it is quite important also to be aware that it can interfere with some blood testing, because the monoclonal antibody is present in the blood and it can interfere with testing for a blood transfusion. And so if this is needed, this is very, very important to be aware of. Also, in the assessment of the response, since the monoclonal antibody, the daratumumab, can be confused with the myeloma protein level, then it can be difficult, if not impossible, to assess if there has been a stringent complete remission. So just some details to be aware of. Now, there are a lot more bits of information that are needed and will be helpful for patients embarking on therapy using daratumumab. And so early in the new year, the Living Well with Myeloma series will incorporate a whole call about the therapies which have been recently approved by the FDA to discuss the use of the drugs and possible toxicities or side effects. And so this is a brief introduction which will hopefully give a sufficient overview to understand the details of this therapy.